Hey, thanks for joining me. I've got Carly with me from the AIM Overseas team. How are you, Carly?
Good, thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks for joining me. Tell me, what's it like when you're shooting down a snow slope the moment before you wipe out?
So you always know that it's coming. Like, yeah. As soon as you do something wrong, you always know that it's coming and there's nothing you can do to stop it. And it hurts.
So just to clarify, we were just talking off camera before we started. It's not to say that you're a bad snowboarder. But I'm just like, literally, because I remember skiing one time just being like, I'm just going to eat it. And you just have this feeling of helplessness,
yeah,
right?
You do. That's exactly it.
Why do you love snowboarding so much?
I don't know. It's just the challenge of like of trying something new. Mm. I've been doing it for a while now, but like when I first picked it up, I was just like, I just had the opportunity to do it, and I'd learned to ski when I was in high school, but I've only ever been skiing one time, and then the next time I went to the snow, I was like, I don't want to do that, I want to snowboard. So I tried snowboarding and I absolutely sucked at it.
Yeah.
Like, it was terrible.
Yeah.
But I'm so happy I stuck with it, because now I actually am kind of progressing, and like, I love it. It's so much fun. I can't get enough of it. It's just
awesome.
You can go so many places with it. That's the other thing I love about it. Mm. You meet really cool people, really fun people as well.
Yeah.
And it's just like that adventure and like action. Like, I'm generally not a super like action packed sort of person, but like that's the one thing that it's just really, really fun.
Yeah.
So fun. Yeah.
Awesome. And where have you been with your snowboarding, skiing?
Mainly Australia, mainly down to Jindabyne and the Snowy Mountains, yep, down there. Try and go there every year. But about a year or just over a year ago, I went to Canada to,
cool,
snowboarding Whistler, which was incredible. And I've been to a couple of smaller places in America as well.
Yeah.
But really tiny.
What's the difference between, because I've never skied in Australia.
Yeah.
What's the difference between like what you experienced over there and here?
So Whistler in Canada, the size of the mountain is just insane,
yeah,
compared to, just no comparison compared to Australia. Australia, after being to Canada, Australia doesn't really have mountains as such.
Sorry, Australia.
Yeah, it's still awesome, it's still fun, but the sheer size of the mountains in Canada is incredible, compared to Australia, yeah.
Yeah, awesome. Where else have you been, travel-wise?
I spent a lot of time in America.
Yep.
Been to America quite a lot. America and Canada are the only countries outside of Australia that I've been to.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. And so how did you end up at AIM Overseas?
I did one of the AIM Overseas programs.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
Back when I was at uni, I...
social media, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a social media for business digital marketing program.
Yep.
I was doing a communication degree at Newcastle Uni, and stumbled across it on our announcements board and our,
yep,
Blackboard site. And it just caught my eye, and I looked into it, and I'm so happy it did, because I,
yeah,
obviously got the experience of the program, but I also got a really cool job out of it as well, which, mm, I was not expecting when I had applied for the program.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you enjoy most about the work that you get to do?
Because
at the moment, like at time of filming, you're heading up the student experience team.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think the thing I enjoy most is it's really exciting and different,
mm,
the type of work we're doing. It is quite niche. It's incorporating travel, which, like, how can you not love traveling? It's fun and exciting. But it's also incorporating that in a more meaningful way than just, mm, going on a holiday. It's you know, actually changing people's lives. Like, they're actually benefiting from traveling, which I think is, rather than just a personal benefit, I think that's the coolest thing. And it's... sort of somewhere that I never thought I would end up, because I didn't really, mm, even know it existed as an industry, like overseas,
yeah,
study. But now that I'm doing it, I just think it's so exciting, because it's so different. And when people ask what you're doing for work, you explain it to them and everyone's kind of like, oh,
you can do
what
that?
Is that?
Yeah.
And then you talk about it more and they're like, oh, that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun and exciting and different, which,
yeah,
I love.
It's cool, isn't it? I just love the facts. You know, that's what gets you out of bed to come to work.
Yeah.
Is like, literally, it's the mission of like, you're changing lives by getting people to go overseas and,
yeah,
study and travel at, mm, the same time, which is awesome.
And you constantly get to see students',
yeah,
photos of incredible places around the world and learn about different places around the world that you didn't even really know existed, or was that a place that you might want to go to. we get to kind of like hear about those experiences and find out about places around the world that I never would have even considered traveling to, but they're now at the top of my bucket list and stuff like that. So that's another really cool thing for me personally.
And where's next for you, travel wise?
Japan.
Oh, sweet.
Definitely Japan. Yeah. Definitely been on the list for a while, so keen to get there.
That'll be very different, won't it?
It will. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, thanks for chatting.
No worries. Thanks for having me.